Hello guys, it's Chris. From massive improvements in vehicle technologies to weapons that seem straight out of science fiction, here are 10 crazy new technologies used by the military. Number 10, hoverbikes. The concept of complete freedom of movement for vehicles is not new to the military, and many vehicles have been developed in an attempt to achieve that capability. The United States Department of Defense is currently developing a hoverbike called the Joint Tactical Aerial Resupply Vehicle, or JTARV, expanding on an original concept and design by British company Malloy Aeronautics. The development of the hoverbike started as a Kickstarter campaign, believe it or not, and teamed up with defense company Service Engineer Co. to come up with the final product. A hoverbike would be very useful on the battlefield. It wouldn't have to deal with things like getting stuck in the mud, sand, or snow, which would be invaluable for use in inhospitable terrain. Moreover, thanks to their ability to quickly escape small, narrow spaces, hoverbikes are being considered as a potential alternative to helicopters for carrying supplies and soldiers. Early in 2017, the U.S. Army successfully flew its hoverbike prototype. It will be a while before it's ready to be deployed, however. The developers of JTARV are currently focusing on making improvements, such as creating a propulsion system that will expand its range to up to 125 miles and enabling it to carry a payload of up to 800 pounds. They also want to make it capable of completing challenging missions, which means installing an advanced navigation system and mission planning. Number 9. Magneto Hydrodynamic Explosive Munition. MAHEM. When it comes to battling armored vehicles, the preferred weapon of choice is a rocket-propelled grenade, or RPG. But thanks to advances in technology, a new type of missile warhead has been created. This is called the Magneto Hydrodynamic Explosive Munition, or MAHEM. Typical RPGs use an explosive charge to fire the rocket head, but here, a magnetic flux generator launches the rocket towards its target. While this may not seem like a big difference, the magnetic version is more accurate and efficient. Additionally, because chemical explosives aren't necessary to launch it, it's safer than previous models. MAHEM uses molten metal projectiles to penetrate enemy armored vehicles. This is more lethal and effective on the battlefield than traditional RPG ammunition. Number 8. Magpul FMG9. In battle, it's not enough to have a good firearm. You must have it at ready and at times concealed, which can be a problem when you have to wear it on your body using a strap or holster. But a new gun may prove to be a game changer when it comes to the ability to conceal one's weapon. The Magpul FMG9 isn't just a fully functioning gun, it's also one that can fold into the shape and size of a laptop battery. Given its reduced size compared to most other firearms, the Magpul FMG9 can easily be concealed without tipping off the enemy. What's just as impressive and important is that this gun can wield a 30-round clip of 9mm ammo, which is one of the most commonly used rounds in the world. At present, the Magpul FMG9 is just a prototype, but it's a functioning one, which is a promising sign for its future. The design could theoretically even be altered to make other types of foldable weapons, including machine guns, which could have a larger foldable size, but would still be less conspicuous than a standard-sized weapon. By the way, are you new here? If so, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on the latest videos. Number 7. Exoskeletons. For as long as there has been war, there has also been the desire to make the soldiers better, faster, and stronger. Technology isn't quite ready for exoskeletons, but there have been many military projects that have aimed to make a functioning and inexpensive exoskeleton designed to boost a soldier's performance on the battlefield. The human body has its limits and can only go so far, run so far, and push or pull so much before its capacity is exceeded. The exoskeleton would greatly alleviate that, enabling the soldier to move much faster and further with less effort, thus increasing their endurance. An exoskeleton would also make soldiers stronger and might even enable them to access places that typically require a vehicle or special equipment to reach, such as the roof of a building. More than likely, you've seen exoskeletons and their potential on various shows, movies, and games such as Call of Duty Advanced Warfare and District 9. Love District 9. Eventually, exoskeletons may not be fictional devices. Number 6. Pack Mule Robot. While we don't quite yet live in a world where sentient robots live alongside humans, the military has long entertained the idea of a robot companion that helps soldiers as they move from one location to another. One recent attempt was a collaboration between Boston Dynamics and DARPA to develop a Pack Mule robot known as the Legged Squad Support System, or L3. The prospective robot was nicknamed Pack Mule because it would aid soldiers by carrying the gear that they would have otherwise had to carry on their own. Depending on the mission and one's role in it, soldiers are sometimes required to carry dozens of pounds of weight, which is tiring and makes it difficult to move around, especially when under fire and in other urgent situations. A Pack Mule robot would lighten the soldier's burden and make them more agile in the battlefield. Because it wouldn't be prone to exhaustion the way humans are, it wouldn't have to stop for breaks. Hypothetically speaking, as long as nothing harmed the robot's wiring and programming, it would be a constant and ever-present companion for the soldiers. Unfortunately, the military announced in late 2015 that they were ending the Pack Mule project because the robot was too loud for use on the battlefield. A loud robot means potentially giving one's position on the battlefield away, and is therefore impractical, and perhaps even dangerous. Just because the project didn't work this time doesn't mean it's been permanently shelved. Although no future experiments or upgrades are currently planned for this particular model. Number 5. Smart Uniforms. Tactical advantages are vital to successful missions, and many technologies have been developed to help soldiers see better, react quicker, and be more lethal when necessary. But that doesn't stop enemy combatants from seeing the soldiers in even the most cleverly camouflaged standard uniforms. In recent years, researchers have designed various smart fabrics to better hide soldiers from enemies. While not foolproof, the smart uniforms currently available are able to obscure soldiers from most night vision sensors, heat vision sensors, and even radar. Once perfected, smart uniforms could potentially make soldiers completely invisible to all instruments, making them only susceptible to the naked eye, which would be a huge advantage in war. Number 4. Liquid Armor. Liquid armor is a type of military uniform that's comprised of a material called Kevlar, which has been soaked in a special liquid and encased, and is used to make soldiers lighter while also keeping them safe. This special liquid is called sheer thickening fluid. When it's not under attack, it's a plain liquid, making it lighter than regular armor, and allows soldiers to move around with ease. However, when it's impacted by a bullet or a blade, for example, the liquid instantly hardens to protect the soldier from serious injury. If you want a hands-on demonstration of how sheer thickening fluid works, you can perform a little experiment at home by mixing equal parts cornstarch and water. You'll notice that if you stir the mixture slowly, it remains liquid. But if you hit it, the surface will solidify. You can also shape it into a ball, and if you stop applying pressure, the ball just falls apart. The military is currently working on multiple versions of liquid armor, including sheer thinning fluid, which is paint-like in consistency and becomes thinner upon impact or when shaken. In other words, it's essentially the opposite of sheer thickening fluid. Number 3. The Corner Shot. One of the most disadvantageous aspects of combat is that, more often than not, you need to be in visible range to fire at a target, meaning that your target can shoot back. And if they're around a corner, that can leave you very vulnerable. Unless you have the corner shot. This weapon is currently used by both law enforcement and armed forces, and is exactly what it sounds like. A gun that can shoot around corners without exposing the shooter. This is done using its extended frame. The gun is no bigger than a regular shotgun or machine gun, but it has a hinge, and this allows the user to turn it up to 90 degrees. The corner shot has a camera on it that loops to a screen in the back half of the gun, allowing the user to see everything the gun sees, and then fire when ready. It takes some getting used to, but it's very effective. It's also versatile and has been outfitted with various pistols and even some grenade launchers. Number 2. Black Knight Unmanned Combat Vehicle. UAVs, or unmanned aerial vehicles, helped revolutionize air reconnaissance and warfare, and the military is looking to do the same thing when it comes to ground warfare, all in the hopes of losing as few soldiers as possible. One such prototype that they're working on is a 9.5-ton tank called the Black Knight Unmanned Combat Vehicle. It's a tank-like vehicle that doesn't have to be piloted from within, making it a valuable item for combat in enemy territory, especially due to the possibility of running over a landmine. The Black Knight also possesses the firepower needed to get the job done and is outfitted with a 30mm cannon and 7.62mm coaxial machine gun, both of which can be controlled remotely. The biggest problem with the prototype, which was first tested in 2007, is that the technology needed to operate it wirelessly on the ground isn't fully refined yet. There have been many communications issues, but if resolved, it could lead to a whole new armor division for the military. Number 1. Laser Weapon System. Laser weapon systems are currently in use by US military, one of the most popular of which is the LAWS, or Laser Weapon System, which works by firing a laser at a target. Now, unlike the lasers you're probably thinking of, it doesn't disintegrate enemy ships and personnel. Instead, the laser causes the systems on the craft or missile it's aimed at to just stop working. LAWS disrupts the navigation and balance of missiles, as well as their targeting systems, and makes the missile spin out of the air and land away from the ship it's targeting. The system also disrupts the engines of an enemy plane trying to come in for an attack run, causing the plane to crash or turn away. One huge benefit of the LAWS is its cost-effectiveness. As long as it has enough power to fire, it can run without issue, and is therefore inexpensive to maintain. Thanks for watching. Can you believe some of the technology the military has or will have soon? What do you think is next to come? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.